Redditors who were atheists but became religious. What happened to make you change? My parents were Protestants but were fed up by the church before I was born. So I was raised without religion. We hardly ever talked about this subject at home. But I do know my parents strongly dislike the Protestant church, although they still like to sing in church choirs. So I was raised without religion. But I think I've always had an interest in spiritual practices. In my early 20s, I started having serious mood issues. Out of self-therapy, I started visiting a local meditation group, which practiced a Burmese technique. This is how I came into contact with Theravada Buddhism. I learned that the Buddha's teachings are very sensible and down-to-earth. No mystical mumbo-jumbo at all. What I particularly like is how Buddhism encourages you to learn from your own experience, not to blindly follow a religious leader. It's basically like, here, this path has liberated me from suffering. You can try for yourself and see if it works for you as well. Not me, but my father. My father was the farthest thing from a religious person you could have ever met in your life. He liked to party, drink, smoke, etc. My stepmother, on the other hand, is very Christian. Well, one day he went to drop her off at church and they were doing faith healing. This was in Brazil. They are very superstitious there. He had gotten into a bad accident back in 1999 and broke his back, so he figured he would give it a shot, and he swears he felt the realignment of his back, like back cracking sound. Hasn't felt pain since, quit smoking, and he credits it all to Jesus. I'm not religious myself, but was very surprised to find out my father was Christian after not seeing him for like 4 years. Doesn't sound like he was an atheist either, just a bit reckless and not bothered by morals taught from scripture. I know plenty of people like that who claim to believe. They just don't care. To be honest, I don't know what I believe in right now. I used to be a hardcore atheist. And by hardcore, I mean I was a huge dong about it. I would go out of my way to avoid making Christian friends or being around them in general. Since then, I have matured and I try my best to be a good person. Partly to make up for who I once was, and because I think that is what it all is about. If you look at any religion, no matter what gods they pray to, no matter what their holy book says, it boils down to how you treat others. And if there is a God, I hope he sees what I have done, the mistakes I've made, the people I've hurt. But I also hope he sees that I've grown, matured, and changed for the better. I decided that I wanted to believe in something again. Sometimes life is rough and it's nice to think there could be something out there looking out for me. I look at religion much more internally now. To me, it's about my personal relationship with myself and my actions. I'm an atheist, but I really wish I could experience something to make me spiritual. It seems to bring a lot of people comfort, and I wish I had that kind of reassurance. I really don't fit the bill, but I figured I'd pitch my 2 cents in. I was raised by a lapsed Catholic and a strong anti-theist. My older sister told me stories of him burning religious books that we had received as presents in the fireplace. He used to sit me down for talks where he would just explain to me for 45 minutes. I timed it once. How there was no possible way to know if there was a God, and anyone who tried to tell me that there was one was lying and bullshitting their way through life out of fear. I wasn't allowed to speak during those talks. There were religious influences from my mom's side, of course, and she still calls herself a Catholic. But she is constantly making far-off comments like, I don't think anyone really believes there's a heaven. Despite those two things, I've sort of always known God was there. It was never a big decision for me, or a big discovery. My dad tried his hardest to shelter us kids from anything religious, but at the end of the day, I still prayed in my room at night. Only back then I just considered it talking. I can remember more than one occasion asking God if he thought God existed. I imagine he found it hilarious. As I got older, I started faith shopping. I ended up doing the Catholic thing for a boy, but I was still really no more than a deist. But as time went on, met another guy, got married, still confused. I eventually got in a very tight spot financially. In desperation, I gave everything up to God and surrendered all control. The next morning, everything felt clear and calm and crisp. I felt like I'd been scrubbed clean, and I got a phone call with a job offer that morning. I consider that day to be when I was saved, although I'd known God for a long time. In terms of Christianity, which has been the biggest hurdle for me. I've become convinced that it is true. The historical evidence for all the different figures, the compelling evidence around the resurrection, and my own religious experiences since then have all culminated in a very strong Christian. However, I also hold that if I am wrong about it all, then at the very least God doesn't seem all that bothered by me being a Christian. And he's the person I most want to please anyway. My dad has been very displeased by the whole thing, and the whole family now sort of treats me with kid gloves. My brothers look at me with more and more detached and cynical looks, and it hurts to know that that's happening, but there's not a lot to be done. I'll pray for you and your family. 3. I know how you feel about being treated with kid gloves. I've been in and out of religion, and whenever I feel really close to God, I'm immediately treated differently. I have a problem with this whole thread. It makes me sad that Reddit, the place that preaches open-mindedness and freedom from bigotry, has played host to a majority of people who apparently are so closed-minded that they don't even realize it. Commenters are attacking people who fit the bill and honestly answered the question, and even a lot of the folks who are just asking questions are purposefully challenging people's faith. While the latter isn't a bad thing in and of itself, I would submit that this thread is not the place to do so. Are we really so presumptuous that we must take it upon ourselves to educate those who are blind and ignorant to the intellectual freedom that atheism has to offer? Atheism is in quotes because many people in this thread misappropriate agnostic values with the term. Let's think about this using a role reversal. If this were a thread about religious folk becoming atheist, would the comment section be this divided? Or would it be people congratulating those who post responses for their freedom from religious idiocy and the bigotry associated with organized religion? I think we all know the answer, because the religious folk on Reddit have learned to keep their mouths shut. Or perhaps they've just learned firsthand what it feels like to have their beliefs disrespected and don't want to turn that onto others. So, proud atheists, maybe think next time before you start to challenge someone's beliefs whenever you hear about them. There's a time and place for everything, and sometimes it's just better to let it go. As for me, I actually have been going back and forth on the whole religion thing. It's a big question, and tough to answer. At the end of the day, I maintain there's no sane way to be 100% sure, and you just have to say whether or not you believe in God, whether or not, when you talk, you think that he's listening. But no matter where I've been on that spectrum, I have tried my darn tutinest to respect all other beliefs and peoples, because they are all valuable. And yes, Jesus said to be kind to others, and many other religious philosophical leaders, but this should remain true no matter what you do or don't believe. While there is still questioning about beliefs, it seems to be a lot healthier and more respectful now, at least near the top. Which is awesome also. To clarify, I was not trying to discourage discussion, but rather talking at people and expecting them to listen to you while not giving them the same courtesy. When things got desperately bad enough that I couldn't come up with anything to do but pray, God answered. Grew up Christian, turned away from God. At 16 my family was hit hard as my mum had cancer. I was hit particularly hard as it was due to a piece of my placenta being left in her womb. I was there, saw the scans. Mum was riddled with cancer and in my mind it was my fault. They booked her in for surgery. I'm from a country with free healthcare. Even with some serious cancer you can get thrown on the waiting list. Then the night before the surgery my dad prayed for my mum and she was like wow, jumped out of bed and said she knew she was healed. Still, she went to the surgery and they did the final scan beforehand. It was all gone. I have had atheists tear me apart and tell me I'm lying over and over and over. I know what I saw. I also know my mum no longer has cancer. Ironically, the basis which men have pushed me with is that if it was real, the media would have reported it. The same atheist saying you can't trust the media in honesty, we tried and they didn't want to hear about it. Like lots of others, I have been a real butthole atheist. You know, laughing at religious people and trying to bash religion with science. One day, in my assholeness, I bought a book named The Bible, The Quran and Science by Dr. Maurice Bucaille in order to put a religious friend down. All I thought before about the connection between religion and science was that there couldn't be any. So I read this book expecting it to be blasphemy itself, but it was showing examples of many Quran verses being scientific correct about subjects. which have been proven and discovered more than 1,000 years later since the Quran was written. Different from the Bible, the Quran remained exactly the same since it was written, about 500 AD. Then I realized that I have never read the Quran before. I did and got actually convinced. I went to our local mosque and the imam answered perfectly every single, also very critical, question I had. Everything he said made sense. Afterwards I was convinced. I want to be a Muslim. Not because of wanting to believe anything, but for the truth. So I became. Since then also this kind of emptiness I felt before was gone. I see that my furious religion bashing in my past was just an act of insecurity, because I saw no sense in life and was afraid of real answers religions are actually offering. After reading Maurice Bucaille's book, I overthrew this fear and started studying the religions. In came to the conclusion that Christianity and Judaism are in fact the same as Islam. But over time the Bible has been turned around and modified. But because of that, the Bible has lots of contradictions and that shows that it simply isn't the truth. The Quran doesn't have one single contradiction and everything scientific which could be researched with today's technology turned out right. There are many scientific aspects in the Quran which aren't proven yet, but that shows that it's the book of God. Because we simply don't have the technology yet to actually make researches about them. I am an entirely new person and very happy with my life. I'm on my phone, so please don't mind typos and spelling mistakes. I was hardcore atheist in high school, to the point where I'd start arguments with people and upset my parents when I talked about it. Modern religion didn't make any more sense to me than Greek, Roman, ancient Egyptian mythology, and concepts like eternal life actually turned me off. Like, what the heck would you do with all that time? A religious friend occasionally invited me to youth group type stuff and sometimes I'd go along for the free pizza. One night, one of the leader guys was saying a prayer for the food and he said something like, "All you have to do is invite Jesus into your heart." And I was like, "Really? That's all you have to do?" I figured if it was balls anyway it wouldn't hurt to try, so I allowed myself to turn off my cynicism for 10 seconds and just did it. There wasn't an immediate change, but I got more interested in religion, almost challenging myself to prove that it wasn't true. Then one day I stepped forward for an altar call, and that change was immediate. I had this old Bible my parents had given me years ago and I remember it had always been nonsense to me. I'd leaf through it to look up verses from books or movies and it was all gibberish. But after the altar call when I looked through the same Bible, it was like it was written in a different language, like it had been in Sanskrit and now it was in English. Words jumped off the page at me and I understood connections between all these different parts of it without even trying. It's hard to explain, and feeling God's presence was like really intense frisson, which was kind of addictive. To this day, I'm still surprised that God exists because it makes no sense to me that he does. I know I didn't make my experiences up because I didn't want God to be real. It's still inconvenient for me that he exists sometimes. But it's kind of like believing in love. Once you've truly experienced it, you know it's real. 1. I decided that I would be better off if I were religious. I admired the religious people around me for their energy and commitment to doing good and I recognized a church as a great support network. At this point, my thought is, man, I wish I could be like those guys. They might be deluded but they look so happy and do so much good work. But religion just isn't for me. I don't think I'd be able to fool myself like they do. 2. I learned that faith can be learned and can grow like a muscle. I learned with missionaries and practiced reading scriptures and praying and almost every time I did I felt good and peaceful inside. I was able to use those feelings and further commit myself to self-improvement and helping others. 3. I learned that the image I had of religious people, ultra-conservative, Bible-thumping, gay-bashing, creationist, didn't apply to every believer. One particular example that really opened my eyes was Ken Jennings, who is a Mormon. People like him showed me that you can believe in God, participate in church, and still hold on to your beliefs in equality and science. I like how you stress good works as a gateway for you to faith. It is something that is very overlooked now in Christianity. Yes, faith is important, but you must practice it by serving others. I was raised Catholic and stuck to that for a while before eventually going godless. I think it was just the standard angry young adult looking to rebel type deal. Just cut religion out of my life and today okay. The big event that led me coming back to the church was being violated. I'd gone without praying for so long. My partner was an atheist who looked down on religious types, but he violated me, and for the first time in a long while I found myself praying. It was surreal the way it distracted me from the pain. Kind of took me out of myself. I was raised in a secular household and from an early age considered myself atheist. Perhaps most would say I still am. I try not to get bogged down in labels. There have been certain things that have changed my perception of this universe. On YouTube I watch the Source channel and they go over certain facts really make me question existence. Like the fact that all the atoms that make our bodies are replaced every 5 years, making us entirely new people on a subatomic level. Or the fact that the photons our bodies emit go out into space and will travel throughout eternity, making all of us sort of immortal. The most interesting theory I've heard is that our universe in a sense is just a giant organism. Electrons circle with protons to make atoms. Atoms combine for cells. Cells give rise to complex beings. Complex beings grow on Earth. Earth and other planets circle a star, creating a solar system. Solar systems group and are collectively nebulas, which group to be galaxies. Would I say I'm religious in the sense that I believe a holy book as fact? Number. Perhaps I even still am not convinced in a benevolent God. I am, however, utterly convinced of a purpose to our lives. If anyone is looking to hear more about this, a man named Lee Strobel has written some great books about similar topics. He was a Yale law graduate that then went on to work a lot with court cases and carefully documenting evidence and all that lawyer stuff. Then his wife one day told him she had become a Christian, so he basically set out to examine Jesus and many other important aspects of Christianity just as he would a court case. He flew all over the country, us, and possibly the world, not sure about the world, interviewing the foremost leaders in apologetics, Bible historians, non-religious historians, and many others. He ended up becoming a Christian and writing 4 books. The books are The Case for Christ, The Case for Faith, The Case for a Creator, The Case for the Real Jesus. He really went into each interview with the objective of nailing down all these famous theologians, and the story of how he got his mind changed is very interesting. It's unique to be able to hear from a well-educated man, used to looking at the raw facts, and hear him make a true case for Christianity. This is the best response in this thread. I've read The Case for Christ and Random Jinger 11 kinda forgot to mention that Strobel was not just an atheist but set out to prove his wife wrong, and completely changed his mind and his life after talking with these believers and teachers of faith. I was atheist all my life until I got really interested in philosophy, especially the trippy stuff like epistemology. The more I thought about faith, the more I realized it doesn't really matter what is right and what's incorrect. A few years ago I became a deist. I don't know if God does in fact exist, but to me he does. I don't have any proof. That's just how I interpret reality. It makes me a happier and better person. I don't think me being right or wrong changes that. I consider myself Christian and was raised atheist by ex-Catholic parents. There are 2 distinct moments that brought on an interest in religion. The first isn't as important, so it will be kind of quick. Having no interest in religion, I was at a concert on a very high amount of LSD. It was right after a brutal breakup from the only woman I ever loved after living with her for years. Basically, at one moment when a song built up, it seemed like everything dropped out from around me. My head ballooned to a gigantic size, and a feeling swept over me. It was just me, the band, and this feeling. I felt as though there was a love everywhere, and I loved everything, everyone, everything, the good and bad in their harmonies. As I had used psychedelics in the past, I at a bit later time tried something called DMT. Now this was a one-time thing I had researched, and I sat in my room alone meditating and preparing. The lights were off. I was ready. I was not really looking for religion, though I had heard some stories of religious visions. In a short version, it felt like hours of a story leading to me transported to a different world full of animals. Now I never believed it before when people said things like this. Maybe it was a dream. Maybe it was drugs. Maybe I'm just a crazy person, but I met God. Who was Jesus? Who was myself? As well as every person, animal, bug and feeling. Now I don't ever talk to people about this when religion comes up. I started reading the Bible and connecting dots in my own ways. I started to go to churches, for the first time ever, to hear different interpretations. Christians have changed so much through time that I have no problem associating myself with a religion and not the standards of today. Christian history is an incredible thing to me, that teaches me more and more about how people have viewed the teachings of Christ. Reaver Aslan said great stuff in his AMA, and I especially like the 6-foot-well analogy. I dug mine in Christianity. Most of what I'm seeing here are people who became more spiritual. I'd like to see a response from a former atheist who now sees the Bible as truth. When I was a kid, up until mid-teenagerhood, I went to a Russian Orthodox church in Australia with my mum. But I was always going through the motions and I never understood it. Having grown up on Australian culture, I didn't understand what they were singing and talking about because I struggled to understand English lyrics at the best of times. So one day I decided that I did not get God, or Jesus, or Christianity, and just basically gave up. This went on for a while, and I had little to no interest in religion. But I did find the memes hilarious. I just didn't get how a God who supposedly loves us would let such awful things happen, and how bad things could exist. But then one day, I started really clicking with this girl, and I really wanted to date her, but she was really really religious. Coming from a really conservative family, partly because of this she broke up with me, but remained great friends. But I just digress, and so I had to bring myself to be interested in Christianity. I started going to her church, which was an Anglican church, so they spoke English. To no shock of mine, I actually started understanding things because of this, and so I realized that God really does love us, that Jesus really did die on the cross for us. I started reading the Bible and read all these amazing stories about what Jesus did and how wonderful he is. People say that there's no real evidence that Jesus was who he was, or that he existed, and while that may be true, it requires faith, which is hard to just have, but I've been able to find it. Also, all the Gospels were written at vastly different times, yet many of the things that are written about intersect and intertwine, which tells me that that stuff may indeed have actually happened. This is a really fresh turnaround for me. My ex only broke up with me last Monday, and yet we are still great friends and I still go to church every Sunday, and it's really fun and interesting. So in short, I turned from casual Christian to atheist to devout Christian through actually understanding what the religion was about, and understanding the Bible, and what Jesus was about. The girl I met was someone that I fell in love with and wanted to marry. We had both agreed that premarital fricking would not be a thing. I wasn't a devout atheist, but I was a man of science. I'd studied physics, so I had a pretty good idea how the universe worked. I'm not really sure why, but I decided that I wanted to find religion. I guess I started thinking about drives the universe. I didn't really feel comfortable with Abrahamic religion, so I started to look elsewhere. I eventually happened across paganism. What appealed me was that it was very much make your own rules, where other religions had some pretty strict ideas about what you could or could not do. As I'd had an interest in Norse culture and mythology, I looked into heathenism, and it wasn't long before I decided that's what I was looking for. I've identified as pagan for only about 2 years now, but I haven't looked back yet. I'd studied physics, so I had a pretty good idea how the universe worked. My parents are non-affiliated, but raised me Catholic because of family expectations. I actually truly believed until I was about 13 years old. I began to notice so much suffering of the innocent in the world. I could not accept that a loving God could allow this. He could wave his hand and ease all suffering. So I became kind of an angry atheist. I convinced several friends to see things my way. But all my life I have been fascinated by the big questions. Why am I here? How am I here? What will happen when I die? I used to have answers to all these questions, but then I didn't have the foggiest notion. So I got older and experienced more of the world and continued to think about those questions. The more time went on, the more my own existence seemed stranger and stranger. I thought it was so unbelievable that I am aware at all, in this time and this place. It's just too good to be true. And gradually the bizarre beauty of the world revealed itself to me. The strange patterns and shapes that reoccur throughout all of nature. The fractal beauty of multitudes of trees upon infinite rolling hills. The fact physical laws have caused hydrogen atoms, essentially nothing, to spontaneously self-complicate, ultimately form moving, feeling macro, molecular vessels that complicate their surroundings to build machines who in turn complicate themselves to build more machines, and so on. This is so utterly bizarre if you can stand far enough back and look at it. I have gotten into a lot of Eastern thought, Buddhism, Hinduism and Taoism. I think they are dancing around the truth. But I have found the Abrahamic religions have great truth as well. The suffering of Christ speaks to me, and submission to the beyond, as in Islam and Judaism, is very peaceful. I feel as if every religion is cloud gazing, but some see different things. But it is all the same. I can't say I've become a religious person, but definitely spiritual. I am content to continue trying to solve the mystery that is myself. It, atheists belittling people's faith. It's painful to watch. So what if someone finds drive and motivation in something you don't believe in? Move on. You guys proved my point. I'm not really seeing it outside of a few fringe comments. I think people are too quick to confuse criticism with belittling disrespect. Just because it is your religion does not mean it is not open to question criticism. I wouldn't say that I've become a member of a particular religion, but having looked at what's out there, they all have pretty key themes of, don't be a dong, try to be a nice person. To that end, I've tried to better myself as a person and my attitude towards other people. With all the religions that are out there, I figure, any god who is as described by their texts would much rather a person be a loving and kind agnostic than an over-the-top angry religious person. Another one-time atheist anti-religious turned Buddhist chiming in. I was raised in the Catholic Church by skeptical parents who felt that the process of personal discovery of God through exposure was important. By the time I was about 10, I was out of accord with the church. By the time I was 13, I was fighting religion tooth and nail. That position slowly weakened as I was exposed to Spinoza and other, more rational approaches to spirit. When I was in college, I encountered Taoism and Zen Buddhism, which corroborated much of my experience, both mystical and mundane. Zen provided a more useful language and, I think, work to deal with Taoism's ultimate truths in a way that was much more pragmatically sensitive to the vicissitudes of a living practice. Ultimately, what brought me back into spirituality was the following. Zen appealed to much of my very visceral experience of the emptiness of mind and self. At that point, I had performed a sufficiently thorough study of foundational logic to realize its systematic weaknesses. Zen's recognition of this appealed to me strongly. As a functioning epistemologist, I had early realized the fact of faith in daily operation, so I had no direct rejection of faith. Zen's systematic cooperation with other, pragmatic systems of thought appeals to me. I have a passing interest in Buddhism, not because of the superstitious or supernatural, but as a life philosophy. There is a lot of truth in religion, if not a lot of facts. Comma, it is a poor thing to strike our colors to God when the ship is going down under us. A poor thing to come to him as a last resort, to offer up our own when it is no longer worth keeping. If God were proud, he would hardly have us on such terms, but he is not proud. He stoops to conquer. He will have us even though we have shown that we prefer everything else to him. Comma, C.S. Lewis. The problem of pain. I realized that I wanted to know the truth about everything, including the things I don't understand. The more I accept and allow myself to understand, the more I learn about myself and the world around me. This is how I understand the sacrifice of giving myself to God. I was a committed atheist and anti-theist, not to mention a Leninist. Around 8 or 9 months from my deconversion, I experienced my first existential crisis and really began struggling for a way out of nihilism and couldn't find it in anything. I tried other religions, focusing on my politics, etc. At one final attempt to get out of that mess, I began studying philosophy of religion and Christian apologetics. Never having really encountered this stuff before, I realized that my reasons for being an atheist were unwarranted, so I dropped it and took a middle ground approach. Finally, after a good 2 months, I had what I consider my philosophical conversation. Soon after, I believe God promoted me into some kind of basic personal experience, which only strengthened my belief. Now I am a Catholic, and have a whole new outlook on life. Even though I still have my day-to-day struggles and problems, I have my life back. Hope this helps you, OP. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.